How do you become a sustainable artist in Nova Scotia?
All right. So at Lighthouse Art Center, we're creating this incubator for the arts. So basically like a Vault of it. For anyone who knows Vaulta, it's basically for tech world. Mm-hmm. So we want to become an incubator for the arts. And that means, again, like I said, meeting you where you're at. So we need to help you understand that there is a business side. You need to talk to an entertainment lawyer. You need to talk to producers and people who know how to take what you wrote on paper and go through all the iterations, all the drafts. If you wrote something that starts with 32 characters, we need to take you to a dramaturge, what's called a dramaturge, to help you pull that main story out and dwindle all those characters down to maybe 10, because 32 costs about $10 million. And yeah. In Nova Scotia, we use, like, there's a program called Talent to Watch. Okay. So that's usually in the industry how a lot of people get their start, is taking that Talent to Watch program. So okay. They're now at about $250,000, and that should be enough to shoot a half decent with like four to five characters, maybe even up to 10. In a feature film, right? Okay. So that's what you can start with, Talent to Watch, as well as at Atlantic AFCOOP, so Atlantic Cooperative, Film Cooperative. They have a program called Film 1 and Film 5. So when you do a Film 5 and when you actually get that, then that's a good start. So what happens is you get into one of these programs, the thing gets made, so now you have this movie, you have this short film, and then you have to shop it around to all the festivals, and you could do worldwide. So now you can go on a website called filmfreeway.com, and that's where all the big film festivals are that grab their content. You know, that you can submit your content there, right? Mm-hmm. So that's Toronto Film Festival, that's Sundance, that's Berlin. Those are like the top three in the world. Mm-hmm. And so my film festival, Emerging Lens Cultural Film Festival, is also there. We're also worldwide, but we're like, you know, we ain't no top 10, but we're getting there. But our film festival is also one of the qualifying festivals for the Canadian Arts Awards. So when you start winning these awards, that's what starts getting you the recognition, right? So those are some, you go through a festival circuit. And then once you go through a festival circuit, then you look for a distribution channel where your piece will live. Okay. So you know how you pick, you said, like Netflix and a drink, right?
Yes.
So you're watching Netflix. Once upon a time, those movies that you're watching on Netflix lived in the festival circuit, okay. Right? And so there's buyers. So buyers will attend these festival circuits and they'll buy up your content for said distributor. So Netflix, Amazon Prime, whatnot. So Lighthouse Go is at my work, we're creating that. So there'll be a local streaming service. I also created one on my own called Ace TV, a cultural evolution television with four partners. And so we call ourselves the Black CBC. So that's also a distribution channel, which will live on Roku. So basically that's the life of it. You know, you create content, and lots of people know how to put it up on YouTube. So all these other programs I mentioned is just a glorified YouTube. It's just a worldwide YouTube.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Was all that possible prior to the internet being a thing? Like, is this recent or all the way? Okay.
This is probably in the last, like, oh gosh, I don't know, 5 years, I'd say.
And so is that presenting new opportunities for folks?
Yeah.
To, okay.
Yeah. And so what actually COVID has done, I guess, on the silver lining side, it's opened up the world for digital content creators, right? And musicians as well. So like, I want to really put out there, you know, rappers and everything like that, don't worry about performance so much. Get into writing scores for film. Get into writing scores for commercials. Get into writing scores for theater. You know, so all the popular ones I know around here, the rappers, I'm like, have you guys ever written any music for theater? No. What? Don't miss your money. Don't leave it on the table. Yes. So anywho, and then just talking about the entrepreneurship side of it. So back to our incubator. So we've partnered with Black Business Initiative, BBPA, who are out of Toronto, but they're actually national. So that stands for Black Business Professional Association.
Yes.
And so we partner with all these folks. We've also partnered with the social workers, the Black social workers.
Okay.
And you might ask, why?
Yes.
Well,
that was my ask. Why?
Let's talk about this. So what happens when, forgetting about this industry and whatnot, when you get like a new job that's like 10 times more than what you're used to getting paid for, you know, you go to school and you become a civil engineer or something.
Yep.
Well, this is a new level. You know, if you've always worked at McDonald's or if you worked at the retail shops or whatever. So now you're a civil engineer. That's a new level in your life, right? So you know the term in our community, new level, new devil.
Mm-hmm.
So basically what we want to help people do in this incubator, while we're incubating their business and their career, is discover what's that new devil for them. and to help them go to their new level. That could be anything. That could be they don't know how to self-care. They don't know how to
manage their money.
Yeah, push out the family's naysaying, right. Push out the community's naysaying. Yeah. You know, who are you to do this? Well, who am I not to? Mm. Frederick Douglass, hello.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, yeah.
And mm-hmm. I would assume that, or maybe I shouldn't assume, maybe I should ask a question. Where did the idea to incorporate the Association of Black Social Workers come in?
Where did that idea come from? I think one day I just kind of said that.
It was new level.
Yeah. New level, new devil.
A black woman who would have been experiencing that, which I think that's the thing that's often missing. Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah. I think there's a part of my experience or thinking around, you know, we are always paying attention to the details that everybody else is going to miss.
Yes. Yes.
I'm going to say that again. We are always paying attention to the details that everybody else is going to miss.
Preach that.
And that is. That's amazing. That part was considered, and I think that that's a testament to the fact that you know
yes.
that would be a need, yeah, right? And yeah. So that makes the incubator program even more successful mm-hmm. before it's even out the door,
right.
Because there is someone who's taken that level of care on the back end to think about that transition, right? So
and even just thinking about being everybody's mom.